You know, former broadcaster here in 3X Wrestling, Jimmy Robb, would say it's main event city around these parts, if you will. I've been looking forward to this one.
I look forward to this one when they just said Fuego was going to defend it against someone.
They said Fuego was defending it. Ethan Page able to get a victory over Moonshine Mantell at Woolies a few weeks back. And Moonshine Mantell, like I said, may have done a little politicking. May have talked his way into this one here. And now you've got triple threat.
Grease some pockets. Potentially. But it's got some good music.
You know, this isn't your grandma's John Denver.
Definitely not. It isn't your grandma's Lightning either.
No, but this is an individual that his wrestling style is one that your grandma was akin to when she was watching All-Star Wrestling. AWA out of Minnesota. Nothing pretty, nothing fancy about what Moonshine Mantell brings to the ring. This is an ox of a man that when he hits you, it hurts.
And it hurts everywhere.
Yes.
Not just where he hits you, but everywhere in your body feels it.
Definitely fired up. Getting a second opportunity here.
I think he feels slighted in not being allowed his title opportunity.
Here we go. Listen to the crowd fired up here. You've seen him on your TV, your television set. He is all elite. He is all ego. Ethan Page making his way here to the ring. And if I'm him, I've got a little bit of a gripe, maybe a little bit of a chip on my shoulder like we talked about. He owns a pinfall victory over Moonshine Mantell. This was supposed to be a one-on-one affair. No longer the case. Triple threat rules. So not only does Ethan Page have to worry about pinning Fuego de Sol, he's got to worry about also not being the one pinned to lose this matchup. We talk about how the championship advantage goes out the window, but the same can be said for the challengers as well. You do not have to be pinned to lose a triple threat match.
Yeah. And the guys in the match could actually get the other guy to submit, and you have no say in it.
You could have no say in the outcome of this one.
So you definitely want to be actively involved in all of the action.
I don't know about you, but things are heating up here at MVP DSM, your 3X Wrestling heavyweight champion, Fuego de Sol. Getting it rallied up here, getting the crowd fired up, knocked off the monarch, Jeremy Wyatt, to become champion.
And that was no easy task.
No easy task. And has proudly held that title ever since. Defended it across the United States and then some. Again, another individual that you see on your television set every week. And that's what we do here at 3DX Wrestling. We bring you all the stars. The stars of today meeting the stars of tomorrow.
All right here, exclusively on 3X Wrestling in Des Moines, Iowa, at MVP Sports.
Ladies and gentlemen, your main event is a triple threat bout for the 3X Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the first challenger to my right, from the great state of Texas, weighing in at...
Say that one more time, just a little bit louder.
I'm not Greg.
Also, he's not in control of the audio. He can't really help how loud the microphone gets.
Talk a little bit louder into the mic. From the great state of Texas is what he said. And soon, you're the next champion.
We talked about he had a little bit of a chip on the shoulder, a little bit of a gripe. Moonshine Mantell, something to prove here tonight.
Obviously not happy with our announcer.
To my left,
actually whisper mine just to prove a point to this dumbo over here that the microphone level is the same no matter what.
Introducing to my left, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 225 pounds. Yes.
Bit of a hot mic there, but the pop nonetheless. And you know, if you're Fuego Del Sol, you gotta be enjoying this. It seems like his two challengers are more worried about one-upping each other than they are becoming champion here tonight.
Giving props to the announcer.
And our champion from Mobile, Alabama, weighing in at 185 pounds, he is the current reigning and defending 3X Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, the master of the tornado DDT. He is Fuego Del
Oh, now we're getting a little bit of John going back and forth here between Ethan Page and Fuego Del Sol. I will tell you, Jeremy, you're probably not too envious right now of referee Brett Miller.
Not in the least.
He's definitely got his hands full in this one.
I do not envy him at all.
It's nice to see that he's able to shake off that stiff boot from Jameson McGregor earlier as well.
Yeah, I'm sure a shot of Jameson helped him.
That's it. Well, you know, he got a shot of Jameson in the face and he took one backstage to get it back on his feet. A little bit of hair of the dog.
Yes. Sound effects.
Bell sounds. We are underway. Main event here. 3X Wrestling Heavyweight Championship on the line. Triple threat rules with, if I'm correct, means there aren't very many rules, right? First pinfall, first submission to a finish. No countouts, no disqualifications. Anything goes in these style of matchups. And right now you see Moonshine Mantell on the outside kind of arguing with the fan right now.
And it looks like Ethan and Fuego are working together. Yep.
It's obvious that out the gate Mantell did not endear himself to either one of his opponents here tonight.
And they are just taking it to...
Ooh. And you know, in a triple threat match like this, the enemy of my enemy can be my friend. You see strange bedfellows happen when the action's like this.
Yes.
Maybe they talked a little bit backstage. When they got together, they said, hey, let's me and you work together. Let's take this guy out. And it's me and you one-on-one. And we're seeing that right now.
Or maybe they just did it in the ring.
I don't know. You know, Moonshine doesn't have too many friends, period. So I'm not surprised right now that he's got two competitors coming at him here. Oh, clubbing shots to the back there. Big old right hand. Ooh.
It's almost a one-upmanship between the
two. It is almost a one-upmanship, yes. Oh, and you hear that working together there. Ethan Page holding him up, calling for a drop kick. Clothesline sends him up and over out of the ring. Goodbye, says Fuego Del Sol. And now, exactly like I said, you take one combatant out of the equation. Now it's down to one-on-one for the 3X Wrestling Heavyweight Championship.
And these two are very good sportsmen. Gentleman's handshake.
Go behind, duck under, into a standing side headlock there. He's got the down to one knee. Ethan Page has the height advantage, but Fuego Del Sol doing a very good job bringing the taller combatant down to him. Down to his level, using his speed and agility there. Going for a flying head scissor. Ethan Page counters. Floats up. Over. Fuego Del Sol lands on his feet. Catches the foot. Up and over again. Fuego Del Sol again landing on his feet here. Both combatant able to have one up on the other. And look at that right now.
Equal respect, equal appreciation.
Neither man able to get an advantage or a leg up.
Oh, Moonshine.
Moonshine making his presence felt right there, sneaking in from behind, a little Pearl Harbor action. And now putting the boots to him. Like I said, nothing fancy about the offense of Moonshine Mantell.
Just by eliminating Fuego out of the match.
Dirty, Nasty. Mantell scoop slam. Dead center in the ring. Comes up again. Leg drop right there.
Snap leg drop. Two count only. Two count only.
Knows right now that he needs to strike while he's got Ethan Page in the ring all to his lonesome right now. While the champion's on the outside. No, oh, Page able to counter. Sends him head first into the top turnbuckle. Oh, Mantell. Big back elbow. Oh, stomp right there to the shin, Jeremy Robb. And the one to the other one.
Ouch.
If you've ever had a little sibling, you know exactly how hard getting kicked in the shin hurts. Del Sol up to the top rope right there. Mantell doesn't see him coming. Oh. Big crossbody float over into a pin. Only a two count right there. Del Sol trying to steal a victory. Moonshine counters, catches a foot coming into the corner there.
Tornado?
Go for that tornado. Tornado head scissors, not the tornado DDT. Ooh, big running uppercut there into the corner. Firing back up, big shoulder tackle into the corner again. Del Sol putting one move after another. No! Oh! And Mantell with a handful of mask just ripping the champion straight down to the canvas there.
That has to hurt. I mean, the whiplash effect on the back of your neck just...
ugh. Just chills down my spine. Yeah. Hitting that mat like that is like being in a low-speed car crash, which doesn't sound effective, but if you've ever been in a car crash, ever hit with an airbag, you know exactly how much all of that hurts. Big boot right there. Did not catch him in the head. Caught him high in the shoulder right there.
Landing definitely hurt.
Yeah. Nothing about that offense was nice, if you will. Oh, taking out the guardrail right there, Ethan Page. Landing in the front row here, MVP, DSM, Mantell's got him up. Oh, my goodness. Brings him up and down, spinning. Oh, I thought he had it right there. Del Sol able to kick out of the spinning brain buster. Gonna take a lot more than that to put away the champion here. But Mantell showing the veteran presence here, staying on him. Again, using that, you know, the lack of rules to his advantage. No count out, no disqualifications, no rope break in a triple threat match. Pretty much left to your own devices in a match like this.
Yeah, the only thing that I think is different is that the falls have to happen within the confines of the ring.
Yes, the pinfall submission has to take place inside the ring, but other than that,
it's fair game.
Yep. Pandemonium, if you will, as the late great Gorilla Monsoon would say.
But the only way to
Fuego
win
Del Sol looked like he was going for that jumping tornado DDT.
The only way to win is to by being in the ring.
Pinfall submission has to take place in the ring there. Mantell showing his size, speed, strength advantage right there, driving for a little soul so far back into the corner that it sent one of our fans in the front row flying off of his chair. Ethan Page back into the ring, back into the mix. Oh, Del Sol catches him coming in with a stiff boot right there. Ducks the line, oh, and one for Mantell over there. A little tabletop action.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
This is not going to end well.
Oh, headbutt right there. Oh, forearm shot right there. Ethan Page got him up and over. Flinging him. Oh, my God. Oh. Into a pin. Only a two count right there.
Didn't hook the leg.
Ethan Page.
Wow.
Beating the MF-er with another MF-er inside the ring right there. Only a two count. Very creative offense right there from All Ego.
That was extremely unique.
Something you're only going to see here in 3X Wrestling. Mantell trying to swat away, trying to create some separation. Ethan Page trying to keep on him here. Shoulder tackle into the corner. Stiff shot. Stiffer forearm. Fuego Del Sol. Oh, Mantell's got both of them in the corner there. Oh, my gosh. And if you notice, Jeremy Robb, every shot. Oh, looking for a double bulldog there. Del Sol able to duck the line. Oh, step up in Zagiri. Oh, super kick. Oh. Big pump kick there. I can't keep up with all this action. Jeez. The feet are flying high and heavy. Down. It's all limbs. It's all legs in this one. All three competitors leaving it all out in the ring.
And is there...
There's no count. I mean...
I guess I'll
figure it out. I guess it could be a triple count out here. The first man to his feet, obviously going to have an advantage at this one. The championship on the line.
If only one gets up, they might win. I've never seen that before.
Ethan Page trying to create some separation, regain his thoughts here. Fuego Del Sol looks like he's going for that tornado DDT. Ooh, counters one into another. Stepping up into a sliced bread dead center of the ring. Fuego Del Sol springboard, moonsault. Oh, no wasted motion into a super kick. Got it all. That's got to be all three. Only a two count.
How did he kick out of that?
He wants that championship right there. But what a series of offense there from Fuego Del Sol, showing exactly why he's a 3X Wrestling heavyweight champion. Move after move after move. A springboard acai moonsault into a seated super kick right on the button. But somehow... Mantell able to kick out, back to his feet, into the corner here. Fuego Del Sol looking like he's going for that tornado DDT. Got him up, floats him over. Moonshine able to counter. Moonshine maybe coming in a little too hot. Able to hold on the rope there, avoids the spill all the way to the outside.
For now.
Del Sol springboards in. Oh my God! Good night!
That hurt. Jesus.
You could hear the crush, or the hush, excuse me, of the crowd. No!
The wind wasn't just knocked out of Fuego, it was knocked out of the whole crowd.
Definitely. All that fire taken out of this, and then hush across the audience as that forearm shot. I think I saw a man's soul leave his body after that one. Like I said, nothing pretty. Oh my goodness, about the offense that Mantell brings. Took a super kick for his effort though. Somehow, I don't know how, the champion able to stand back to his feet here. And again!
Another MF-er with an MF-er.
Just using the body of the champion as a weapon here. Then now Ethan Page waiting, buying his time, waiting for Mantell to get to his feet here.
And it was a legal weapon.
A legal weapon. There, I mean, any weapon in a triple threat match is illegal. But one of the combatants is looking for that springboard cutter here. Coming in. Oh, catches him coming with the boot. Time, double A spine buster. Only a two, and right there we could have had a championship change hands without the champion having to be pinned.
Oh my goodness, that was so close.
I don't know how Del Sol's up to his feet right now. I don't understand it.
Championship perseverance.
A lesser man.
Oh no.
Floating over. Got him into a pinfall cover here. Mantell rolls out, looking for that tornado DDT. Spikes him dead center in the ring. That could be all, into a pin.
One, two.
Ethan Page.
Saving his chance at that championship.
I mean, you couldn't put a piece of paper between referee Brett Miller's hand and the mat right there, but Ethan Page somehow able to break it up right there, keeping this match alive, like you said. Got him up.
Oh no.
Got him up on his shoulders, looking for a razor's edge. Float over. Del Sol, what a maneuver. Oh, what a knee. Looking for, again, that tornado DDT. Just throw him out.
Oh! Inside out. What the?
Ethan Page got him up.
One for
got him
again.
Up on that razor's edge. Just launched him.
And it's legal.
Completely legal within a triple threat match.
And we have a new 3SW heavyweight champion in Moonshine Mantell.
Moonshine Mantell steals it right there. Moonshine Mantell First of all, he politics his way into this matchup to begin with.
Oh, he's got something he wants to say.
He's not done with him yet. But like we talked about, there are no rules in a triple threat match. One south of the border, south of Texas, to Ethan Page. Moonshine Mantell, let all ego Ethan Page do all of the dirty work, hit him with his best shot, and then came in, pulled the underhanded tactic, but completely within the confines of the rules in a triple threat match. As you know, former head official here, 3X Wrestling Skeletor, no disqualification in a triple threat. And just like that, we've got a new champion. Congratulations, I guess, to Moonshine Mantell.